regard this meeting. Today first concept name is inheritance. Today first concept name is inheritance.
Inheritance.
What is inheritance? Inheritance.
We can get by family, like fathers.
Yes.
Some qualities come to the child.
Yes. Inheritance. Right, ma. That is the concept only. Inheritance is the one of the concept. Provided by Java. Which is used for extending the parent class stuff to child class. Parent class stuff. Stuff means properties. Stuff means properties. Parent class stuff to child class. Inheritance is one of the concepts provided by Java. So which is used for extending the parent class stuff to child class. We can extend the all the parent class stuff to child class. We can extend the all the parent class stuff to child class. Just you should remember here only one thing, madam. A extends B. A extends B. That means B properties will come to A. A extends B means B properties will come to A. A extends B means B properties will come to A. B properties will come to A.
A.
Right. For example, yesterday we have discussed one concept. The concept name is static properties and non-static properties. And we have taken only one class, that is a by class. Under class we wrote functions and we called from main method. We called from main method.
Main method. Yes, sir.
Today concept is totally different. Here I am taking one father class. Father and the son class, grandson class. Each and every class I am giving two functions. First one, father, he can drive car. Drive function I am giving. And earn function I am giving. Earn function also I am giving. Driving and earning. Two functions I am giving. Son, I am giving two functions. Drink and smoke. Drink and smoke. I am giving two functions, drink and smoke. I am taking another class, grandson. Grandson. Play and study. Play and study. Two functions I am giving. Father always having two properties only. Just father having only two properties only. Now I am extends. Son extends father. What will happen?
Four.
Son can
son get. Son extends.
Father.
Son. Father. Yes, sir.
What will happen? Tell me.
Drive and earn we can exchange from the father to son.
Yes. So father class function will come to son. So son can get four properties.
Okay.
Grandson extends the son. What will happen?
We'll get six. Grandson having six properties. Drive, earn, drink, smoke, play and study.
Yes, six properties he can get. So today concept is totally different concept. So here I am taking three different classes and we need to take another main class and we need to call the all the function from main method. We need to take another class. So we need to call the all the function from this main method. So totally here we should take four classes. So inheritance concept, first of all we should know how to manage different classes. After that we can implement inheritance concept. First, we should know how to manage different classes. Yesterday, we have taken only one class, that is a by class. Under class, we wrote functions and we called from main method. But today class is totally different. Today class is totally different. Today class is totally different. So, your father class we should take and son class, grandson class, another main class. Okay, four classes we should maintain. First of all, we will discuss how to maintain or manage different classes. After that, we will discuss inheritance concept. Okay, right.
Okay, sir.
Next concept. Today, next concept. Overloading. Next concept name is overloading.
Overloading.
Overloading. What is overloading? If at all, a function existing in parent class, if at all a function more than one time in a class, if at all a function more than one time in a class, more than one time in a class, if at all a function more than one time in a class with different arguments, like with different arguments, different arguments like type of args, comma number of args, if we write then that concept is overloading concept. If at all a function more than one time in a class with different arguments like type of arguments, comma number of arguments, if we write then that concept is called overloading. Same function we are writing number of times but with different arguments, with different arguments, with different arguments, with different arguments. Same function we are writing
with different arguments.
Same function we are writing number of times with different arguments, like type of arguments or number of arguments I am changing. So that concept is called overloading concept. Before going to overloading concept, first of all we should know what is variable. What is variable? Variable is nothing but it is a name. Variable is nothing but it is a name. Variable is nothing but it is a name given to a one memory location. Which can hold a value. Which can hold the value that value will be changed in future. That value will be
changed in the future.
Be changed in future. That is called variable. That is called variable.
Variable.
It is a name given to a one memory location which can hold a value. That value will be changed in future number of times. How many times you want, that many times we can change the value. So this is the memory location. That name is A. A equal to 10. This is the name given to a one memory location which can hold a value. That value will be changed in future number of times. Data type, variable name equal to value. Data
syntax,
type, variable name equal to value. Syntax. Data
okay.
type, variable name equal to value. Data type is into.
Into float.
Variable name equal to A.
Character.
Equal to 10.
A.
Data type, variable name equal to value. Into A equal to 10. This is the variable. This is
A
the variable.
Variable.
Right. Data type, variable name equal to value. So this is the theory
what?
Part. This is the theory part.
What?
This is the theory part.